They have big ears and a long neck. You're my lady.
We've got the final memory. Let's hurry.
Mm-hmm. Not now.
Thank you.
away from me!
I'm sorry. I never meant to. It's too much.
Your gift? What happened to his arm? Don't worry, we'll fix him up.
And welcome to Teddy's Grand, the Museum of Among the Sleep. Go on, take a look around. The prologue was added as a free DLC a couple of months after release of the game. It was made in collaboration with some of our fans and made to elaborate a little bit on what went wrong with the parents' relationship. That the mother was not simply evil, but rather that relationships are tough and neither of the parents handled it well. Oh, you're home. The team wanted to start with introducing the character of the mother, as well as the mechanics of the game. Starting with the kid's birthday was a way to both introduce Teddy in the form of a gift and showing how old the kid is. When night falls over the home is when you really start seeing the ways in which the child perceives reality while scared. A large part of the game is based on how children see and interpret what's happening around them. The playground. There's something walking around here, but you never see it. The passive threat keeps you on your toes, and at the same time creates the illusion that you might be safe for the rest of the game. This is the forested home. It's a crumbling home that's slowly rotting away into the water and trees. The house here is a symbol of the family and home falling apart. The bloated creature inhabiting it is how the kid sees his mother when she's drinking and full of sorrow. There you have it, me, or old me, as now I'm just a floaty version in your memory, of course. Also, here are all the characters in Among the Sleep, old and new. Some are not used, and some are hard to see because of the various tricks and lighting we did to obfuscate them. Ah, my favorite place. I felt we really connected here, you know? A bit of a breather between the various bad, nightmarish worlds we went to. Also, I was able to talk a lot here, as elsewhere the developers were concerned about keeping the tension up and didn't want me to say too many things. Also, I kind of get quiet when scared, so it's okay and all. But I liked best the times we had to catch up. This is the reveal. This is where you see your mother for what she is, and the player gets to connect the various monsters and sights to the game. Now here is something truly special. Want to see what the game almost was at some point? This is an old version of the story's conclusion, and it's been something we have not shown anybody except a few testers in the early days. You might say here, I got to have more fun than in the original ending. Come in and see. extraordinary. Round and round and round. Places go in. Five little animals with only steps deep hill. A snail that dreams of climbing trees, but never will. A hungry, starving hippo whose gummies are red, and her best friend seagull lying lifeless and dead. And now for the main ingredient. Thank you. You did very well. I will enjoy you very much. Originally, the chase for the mom was a MacGuffin. You did not really find her, and the monsters used her to lure you further into the dreamlands. And we struggled for some time to make sense of this story, especially the playtesters were confused as the story ended without you seeing your mom again. Did you know that you can collect hidden drawings throughout the game? If you do, they will appear here in this room. There might even be a reward if you can find them all.